Hello, this is Swati Mari and this video explains how to use Turbo Prolog and basics of the Prolog language. Learning objectives of this video are: students are expected to use Turbo Prolog as a software, write simple Turbo Prolog programs and execute the same. Now about installing Turbo Prolog on Windows. So Turbo Prolog is a DOS-based software. To use it, one need not install it, but one must have a copy of Turbo Prolog software or the unzipped folder in their own system. If you are running the software on Windows XP or any earlier systems, then one could directly run prolog.exe to run the software and to start the IDE. But in case if you are using Windows 8 or onwards operating systems, then one has to install DOSBox to use the Turbo Prolog program. So let us look at how we can run Turbo Prolog using DOSBox. So the user has to run DOSBox software to get the command prompt, which will be Z prompt when you start the DOSBox. DOSBox lets us mount a file system virtually. So currently I have my Turbo Prolog software folder located at D drive Prolog. So I am running the command as mount C space D drive Prolog. Upon success, it will give me message as drive C is mounted as local directory D drive Prolog. Now to go to the installed virtual file system, I'll have to change the drive name from Z drive to C drive. So when I go to C drive, it's not actually C drive, it is D drive Prolog, the one which has been mounted over there. And this D drive Prolog folder contains prolog.exe, which I am going to run over here with Prolog. In case your D drive Prolog folder contains subdirectories which finally contains prolog.exe, then you may have to use the commands cd, that is change directory, go to the appropriate directory and run prolog.exe or prolog to start the Prolog IDE. So once you start the Prolog IDE, this is how it looks like. You may create a new file with Alt+F+N, or you may load existing file with Alt+F or F3 as hotkey. Then you may go to any one of these menus by pressing F10 plus these orange letters. For example, to run the program, you may type F10 plus R as a combination and run the program. How to open an existing file? For the same, all the Prolog files in Turbo Prolog software, they use .pro as the extension, and Turbo Prolog comes with pre-coded examples and re-examples directories. Examples directory contains relatively simple to moderate level knowledge representation and reasoning programs, while re-example contains relatively complex programs dealing with reasoning process. Use your cursor to go to examples directory and open the first program in the same. After the program loads, the IDE gets divided into four sections: editor, dialog, messages and press. Editor is the section wherein you write the program. Dialog is the window wherein we execute the program. Message window gives us the system messages, and when we debug the program, the flow of control or the predicates which are getting executed will be seen in the trace part of it. So now let us go to the sample program and understand structure of the program. Each Prolog program is divided into four logical parts: domains, predicates, clauses and goal. Some of the sections are optional, some of the sections are not. The first section in the Prolog program is domains, which contains the variable declaration. Prolog allows data types such as integer, real, string, symbol, etc. Though this is an optional section, it improves readability of the program. This section does not exist in SWE Prolog or Visual Prolog. Going ahead, next logical section is predicates, which includes all the predicates, that is, relations which we intend to use in the program. It may contain one or more predicates. For every predicate which is declared over here, there has to be a corresponding clause in the clauses section. That is, to use any clause in the clauses section, it has to be declared in the predicates. And whenever we declare anything in predicates, it must be used at least once in the clauses section. This predicate section is compulsory in Turbo Prolog, but is optional in SWE or Visual Prolog. If you do not use domain, then data types are written as predicate arguments. For example, if I do not use name comma sport as symbol, then my predicate would be written as likes symbol comma symbol. And predicates do not end with a period, while clauses, whatever are written, they end with a period. So next logical section is clauses, which is a compulsory part across all Prolog flavors. That is, it is compulsory in Turbo Prolog, SWE Prolog, as well as in Visual Prolog. And this section contains facts and rules. If you have more than one predicates used in the program, then all the clauses belonging to the same predicate must be written together, no matter if they are facts or rules. Again, this rule holds valid across all the Prolog flavors. For example, in this program, if you would have to use two predicates such as likes person comma sport and plays person comma sport, then we will have to write all clauses belonging to likes in one group and all the clauses belonging to plays predicate in the another group. We cannot interleave them, like one predicate belonging to likes, then some predicates belonging to plays, then some predicates belonging to likes, etc. In such case, Prolog program will give us error for the same and the program will not be executed. Fourth and last logical section is goal, is optional in all program flavors. This is generally used only when you would wish to start the program execution with a particular point. For example, if you want to load graphics, or if you want to load menu, or if you want the execution to start with a particular statement, then we give that in the goal section. Otherwise, we use the dialog section to execute the program. Now, this current program talks about who likes which sport. So whenever the statement includes exact names, it's some knowledge which is true in some or other domain. So it is called as a fact and ends with a period. If you define a rule, then generally it contains free variables, that is, any word whose first letter is capital. One can just use a capital letter or an entire word wherein the first letter is capital. So this last sentence in the sample program defines a rule that if Tom likes any activity, then Bill likes the activity. The rules generally contain one or more preconditions, which when all of them are true, the left hand side is true. The rule separates left hand side and right hand side with the word if or a colon followed by a hyphen. You can see an example over here wherein the word if is not used, but instead we use a colon and a hyphen. Multiple conditions can also be used and they can be put together by connecting them with a comma or with a word and, and. In case if you want to use or option, then you may use the word or in otherwise cases. But it is advised not to put or conditions in the same clause. Instead, one should write them as separate clauses, as it is shown in this particular example. So, for example, one should not write clauses as likes Mark comma sport if likes Bill comma sport or likes Alan comma sport. Instead, one should separate them as likes Mark comma sport if likes bill comma sport and another predicate likes mar comma sport if likes Alan comma sport. This improves readability of the program and reduces chances of getting wrong set of conditions being checked in the same. One should be careful while writing the clauses as we are habitual of writing people's or places names starting with a capital letter, which might be considered as a free variable. If you must use capitalization as part of argument, then the word must be enclosed in the quotes and then one can use the capitalization. But Prolog is case sensitive, so Alan where E is small and Alan where E is capital, they will be treated differently in the program. Now let us go to the part of executing the program. You may run the program with Alt R or F10 R. This will highlight the dialog window. If you wish to go back to the editing part, you may simply press Alt E or F10 E. In the dialog sections, we can fire various queries. We generally use free variables to get the answers to our queries. As it is earlier said, we can use any letter in capital to be treated as free variable, or any word whose first letter is capital and then it becomes a variable. You may use same variable in the program because it gets used only once while checking and matching with the other predicates. So if you wish to know who likes which of the sports, then you can write likes open parenthesis any capital letter comma any other capital letter close the parenthesis and enter. Remember, there is no period at the end of this query. So this gives you all the combinations of X and Y, where X stands for person and Y stands for sports. Now one has to be very careful about spelling of the likes predicate written in the program and written in the query. Also, number of arguments in the query and the number of arguments given in the predicate which is used in the program, and likewise. The output of this query will be all possible combinations of people and sports they may like. So here you may see the capitalization of Alan is stated separately. You may also check if what all sports are liked by Alan by running likes open parenthesis Alan comma any capital letter, which is a free variable. So we get only one answer, P equal to tennis. Similarly, if you want to know who all like tennis, then similarly you can write likes any capital letter comma tennis, and you will get all the combinations wherein B stands for some person's name and tennis will be the sport that they like. So this way you may go on adding predicates in the predicate section and accordingly increase the knowledge base in the clauses section and execute the program. Thank you.